Hello everybody, how's it going? My name is InkEyes, welcome to my channel and welcome to InkEyes Plays for the King. Alright, so, okay, couple of things, real quick, very important things. One, so I love this game, you should too, get this game, it's freaking awesome, but it's also so damn difficult. So here's a secret that I'm gonna let you in on. I had recorded 3 episodes for you guys, for a backlog, just to make sure that I have episodes coming out every day. And then they ended in horrible failure. And then I was like, you know what? No. This is not gonna fly like this. So I started recording. I scrapped those 3 episodes and I started recording 3 other episodes, brand new episodes. And I explained in those episodes that I deleted those episodes, the previous ones, in interest of better success because I've learned so much, right? Well, guess what? I scrapped those 3 episodes too. So I have scrapped a total of 6. Episodes. It pains my heart. A lot of amazing things happened as far as like events and dramatic stuff and commentary and humor and chaos and whatnot. But so be it. We're on episode 5 of the series, and I would hate to usher us into episode 5 with more defeat. I want to succeed. I have an additional 3 hours of experience through those 6 scrapped episodes. Evidence of that, if you don't believe that I've played so much, take a look at this. I have 4 lore on top of having already unlocked a Trapper class, Swift Shoes, and the Dark Carnival. And I still have 4 of the doobly-doos. I still have 4 lore left. So that should give you an idea that I've been trying, okay? So we're gonna jump in, we're gonna do solo adventure again, we're gonna go and refuse to go down to easy, okay? Normal! Oh my god. This game is harder than hard games. That says a lot. I think Rebel needs to change. I think Kara needs to change, and I think Rebel needs to change as well. So, Karen is no longer going to be a minstrel. Karen is now going to be... I want Karen to be a scholar, though. God damn it. She looks great as a trapper. You know what? She could stay a minstrel. You know what? I want Karen to be my minstrel. Karen, you remain minstrelly. But Rebel, you need to change. You need to become... I think Rebel needs to be my... the scholar. We need a scholar so bad. And the scholar is going to be of color red. And he shall possess powers beyond your wildest comprehensions. You can't. Basically, you can't comprehend it. You're going to be such a wizard. Red does not suit you, my friend. Red does not... Yellow does not suit you either. In fact, I'm not a huge fan of any of these shades of colors. They're just not, like, the best of the colors. Like, these... I don't like any of these blues. Definitely not this one. Definitely not... I mean, this is fine. You don't have to look so Irish, you know? It's a little better. Alright, starting it. Let's go. Alright, so what is going on? There was King Broner once upon a time. He got killed and then chaos started spreading through the land of Farul. And then we started looking for his friend, Broner's friend, Vexer. And the queen has called upon us, the citizens of this land, to right the wrongs and find out exactly what is causing chaos and stop it if we can. And in order to do that, we need to go find and meet Hildebrandt in Woodsmoke. And we have 14 rounds to finish this entire quest. There are still things in the game that confuse me. I shall perhaps ask the dev. There we go. The things that confuse me are things such as, does it matter the turns pass in dungeons. Like, what I do know is that if you go into a dungeon and then your people die and you still have room for chaos to grow, then you can actually revive your dudes in the same battle. However, one thing that is not clear is it in my best interest to just use all my turns before going into the Glittering Mines, or what? What is Glittering Mines, you ask, if you're new? Glittering Mines is the location of this underground operation, apparently, that's contributing to all the chaos in the land. And what we need to do is we need to really take advantage of opportunities to get experience. And in my last playthrough that was not on camera, these bees, man, holy crap, these bees. My last playthrough that was not on camera, what you guys missed was me discovering the benefits of upgrading your pipe. Oh, by the way, press T, get the stats up. Upgrading your pipe, and I also realized that perhaps you don't want to upgrade your pipe maybe on not on the first objective. Like, I would rather save all of my money for herbs. Herbs are super duper schmooper klooper important. And the reason I'm taking this dude, the reason Rebel this time is a scholar, is because of this area attack. I need these group attacks. They become pretty crucial. There's so many things that are crucial and you don't know that until you gain experience. And I think right now, with all the skipped episodes, I think I am sitting where I would be a little more comfortable as far as my experience goes to have a decent chance at this quest at hand. Using this to replenish some focus, I think I want to give this to somebody who has lower focus, who can benefit actually from higher focus, which would be Rebel. Because the group attacks, they have lower accuracy, and there are times when we will want to hit with the group attacks, for sure. Permanent increased magic resistance, I want that to be Shadow Man's. Use it. Using this herbal plant, some focus. I think the second one should go to Karen, because she has stun, and I would love her to be able to land stun when needed. If I must use focus to do that, then that's just something that's gotta happen. So yeah, it's going to be very, very, very important to try to focus on purchasing herbs as many as we can. So what I want to do, first of all, I want to check out the prices for these herbs at this location. This place has 3 God's Beards, which replenish HP, which I will want for sure. For 9, we could take a couple of them, actually. Like right now. Whose turn is it? Shadow Man? Okay, by the way, another thing that I learned is like turn order. The person in the middle is their turn, and then this queue moves to the right the same way that the daytime moves to the right, and the battle queue, the combat queue for enemies, also moves to the right. So Shadow Man, once his turn is over, he's gonna move to the right and take the place of Karen. Karen's gonna move over to Rebel's slot. Rebel is going to move into the middle, and this conveyor belt is gonna just keep moving to the right, and the person being in the middle is going to have a turn, meaning Rebel is going to be next. So that's just one good way to keep in mind who's gonna go and do what and whatnot. And what I want to do is I want to make sure that we give money to Shadow Man. Give all your money. Give it all. I don't care. Just give your damn gold to this man. And then this man, 3 times 9, 27, you still need more. This man is going to refresh the market. He's going to purchase God's Beards. Then he's going to open his inventory and he's going to give one of these God's Beards to Karen. Yeah. Rebel doesn't need one right now because I'm what I'm doing in my mind. I'm like, all right, she has one extra point of focus, or he'll be fine. He'll be all right. All right. Okay. Quest board. Good time to quickly take a side quest, which could be potentially on our way. I think I would want one with very much gold, like this one. This retrieval helped me get a decent reward for any brave soul willing to retrieve the leather pouch from the parrot. And then hand deliver it to us. Where is this parrot? Where is parrot? Hold on. I'll take it. I accept it. Very far away. Pretty far away. Excuse me? What is that? A letter pouch from parrot delivered to Queen's Landing. Alright, so we gotta take it over here. Is this Queen's Landing? Is parrot dangerous place? Provide shelter, equipment, services, and extra work. Alright, good. No, it's not a dangerous place, but I don't think we are going to have time to engage that side quest. We need to, like, really mainline toward this sub-objective of meeting Hildebrandt in Woodsmoke. So, we need to move out quickly, swiftly, and not get caught along the way either. So head out over there. A beautiful day. Beautiful day indeed. What is this? Sunken wharf. Oh, by the way, you see the ocean vessels? Yeah, one day we shall embark on the seven seas. Loot, sweetness, carnival ticket. Wonderful. I've never actually had a carnival ticket. Maybe we'll be able to use the ticket at the carnival here. We're gonna hope that Karen gets a really high roll for movement. It's decent. It's decent. It's actually pretty decent. Catch up with the rest of the party. I'm willing to actually sacrifice one turn to pick up the carnival ticket from Rebel. Give it to Shadow Man and have Shadow Man come check out this carnival. We've never done this before. Ooh. Masked storytellers and still stuck around on a bonfire while filthy clowns tempt you to body shows and games of chance. Time was villagers with pitchforks and torches would run this sort of nonsense out of town. Times have changed. So there's a chance we regain all of our focus if we had spent any. We cannot use focus here. There are multiple games for multiple different things with different amounts of rolls. We do want to go for something that has lower number of rolls, not five, maybe the four ones. But what do we see here? Gold, focus regain, next level. You level up, 3% chance of leveling up. I mean, that's something that I would not dare do. Full party heal. Something that I would shoot for. Gain item 25% chance or gain gold 25% chance of nothing. 6% chance of death, which I doubt would happen. 16 gold treasure chest. Gain item. Plus 2 skip turns. That would be awful. I want to do this middle one. Wow. Okay. Alright then, we don't have a ticket anymore, man, so it's not tiered, it's literally one of those effects, and we rolled for the highest, which is totally fine. A full party heal is going to allow us to not be forced to camp, basically, outside of Gillery Mines, or whatever. I think that's what's gonna happen. Like, we are gonna eventually need to camp and stuff. Zero level hag when Karen is that far behind, I think it's worthwhile. In fact, maybe we can walk, like, pass through here instead to Woodsmoke. I don't know what the terrain is like here, but we don't get a lot of encounters up there, but we can engage in like four different encounters at least down here, which will be super, super, duper beneficial. Alright, let's go engage this hag. Let's ambush it, because there's no reason not to. Failure, fortunately, does not have any malices. The hags can, however, can set you on fire. Wow. Rebel? You're worrying me a tiny bit? You already lost like half of your HP. Please. This is not supposed to be happening this way. Good dodge. Something that did disappoint me in the playthrough that you will never see is that I had a 50 evasion with Shadow Man, and then two turns in a row he was unable to evade, which was really making me mad. You take this, equip this. Like, I was wondering, then how high does your evasion need to be to benefit from it? If 50 is not good enough? So this is Glittering Mines. It is extremely close to Wood Smoke. But the problem is, Wood Smoke is not going to be our only pit stop. We need to go from Wood Smoke to the Cult Device. And then from the Cult Device... Yeah, we have... Oh gosh, we have so much to do. Okay, get a move on. More adventures that we can loot. Gold multiplier. Collect it. Negative resistance, negative strength. But gives you intelligence, and you do need intelligence. Take it. Okay. Ooh, this command line makes me worried. I hope the game doesn't crash since that popped up. End of turn! Karen, you are really far away. This guy, next to the zero, you see like a bunch of people. Those that icon means that there's a chance of this being a swarm of enemies. Which would really suck. I don't want to fight them. Might as well, actually. You know what? Rebel's half HP. Go in here. Get experience points. You are out of that other combat situation. So Shadow Man and you are going to handle this, hopefully professionally. I expect nothing less from you. Three crows... shouldn't be too bad. Just gotta make sure that we do take them down quickly. Oh god. Yeah, just focus on the middle one. Barely got it. That's not what I want to see. These crows are relatively quick. But nice dodge. We're gonna target that right one. Dead. Sadly, Karen may not... Oh, never mind. I take that back. Oh, zip your mouth, boy. We got gold. We got a camp, which is awesome. Take it. Definitely went much better than I expected. It's okay. I know you don't have a ticket. Pass the turn. Shadow Man. Catch up with Rebel here. Or not. Shit. Alright, could be just one dude. We're gonna ambush this one dude. Ambush failed. Don't mind it. It is one dude. He gets to attack first because of failure to ambush him. We are taking heavy damage, man. It's heavy damage. He has armor, so I need to do armor piercing. Encouragement is great. At least make sure guarantees that we can actually hit the dude. Shadow Man is getting wrecked. There we go. Daze it. Get a couple of attacks for free, hopefully. Come on, do a little better than that. We need a little bit more damage than that, you know? Yeah, there you go. No magic resistance. We wrecked. Extra magic damage. That needs to go to Rebel. And who's standing next to Rebel right now? I think... it's Shadow Man. Collected. Or will be standing next to Rebel. Alright. Give that to her. The Spirit Taffy. And then she needs to eat that, like, right now. Oh, she needs to eat it. In combat. Okay. Fair enough. Do you have anything that you need to put on? The lucky coin could go to Shadow Man since he doesn't have anything like that. He has a free slot. Equip it. There you go. All right, nice. Good. Okay. So far, not too terrible, honestly. We still have 12 rounds. No, we're okay. We're okay. Shadow Man is pretty hurt, but that's fine. What is this? Wisdom, full HP, and experience multiplier. That is something that I think Shadow Man will have to take advantage of, but in turn. Rebel, of course, gets full movement points in a situation where it's not even needed. So we're forced to pass a turn unless I... move her forward? Is this the sort of teleport that allows you to... Is this the sort of teleport that allows you to pick the location? Is it a random teleport or a specific teleport? I am not sure. I would like to try it. Okay. Okay. Why don't you go there? A land hex. It can't be wood smoke. Okay. If that's the case. If that is the case. Escape to cancel. You cover that spot. Fair enough. I'll teleport over here. Oh, she still gets to move? No way. If that's the case... Whoa! Wishing well. There's something strange about this well. Tradition holds that you should toss in some money! Drink from it. Throw coins in it. I cannot use focus. We are going to throw coins in here. Negative 5 coin. Nothing happened? Jesus. Oh wait. Odds went up. Drink from it? Oh my gosh. Poison is the worst thing ever. Poison does not wear off automatically. You need to address it. And it gives you a huge debuff. Huge debuff. Wow, another loot. Max HP, health regeneration. You know what? Wear it. Armor and resistance, wear it. Plus 2 movement, use it. Wait, what happened to Rebel? She lost all her bonus movement points because of the poison. That sucks. I don't want to attack this camp yet. All right, end of turn. We need Rebel back, and we need her healed up. Oh, what a waste. Wow, she couldn't get a little closer? Well, let's attack this guy, first and foremost. Hopefully it's not gonna go terribly badly. It's just a stun attack that did not land. He does have armor. Cold shot, perfect shot. Beautiful. That's not good. Shadow Man did heal on the map while we were waiting around. Nice. Pretty decent. We do need to eventually level up, please. If possible. Please level up, guys. Oh, shit.
All right, Karen, time to do this. Ambush it. Wait, it did say that these camps can't get ambushed, right? I thought that was a thing. Ooh, that's okay. Actually, Karen is the healthiest of them all. Let's have the last one get attacked first, because hopefully by then she'll be out of the equation and we don't have to worry about her. Very nice shot. Now, keep focusing on that guy. And just tear her a new butt. And then, at this point, it doesn't matter who goes. We're gonna get attacked twice. Hopefully it's not going to kill us. Please don't murder me. Karen! Rebel! All of you. This one. Kill this one. That's okay, we're gonna have the AoE attack, so actually attack that one over there. And then we're gonna deal 3 magic damage across the board. Does focus increase the damage? It does not, it just increases accuracy. 69%! Well done. Her spell fizzled, I'm all for that shit. Okay, last one, you're dead, goodbye. I wish the last attack was a critical, so that not that we got hit by the last attack that fizzled, but still, using a sword will boost the will give a boost to experience gained permanently. Let's collect it for now. Teleportation scroll, give it to Shadow Man. All right, take a sip of my coffee here. And there goes my timer, actually, for the episode. But I do want to get closer to the town and, in fact, take care of my people in the town. Nice inspiration. You actually inspired her to level up him. There's another ambush that we can set up here. There we go. There we go! Alright, this guy's hopefully dead. We all get to attack him. He doesn't have any armor, so let's just deal straight up the damage if we can. And daze him? This could be enough. And it was. It was a perfect attack. It was the perfect encounter. Except for Karen. Come on, Karen. Step up to the plate. Alright. Nobody's using strength. And we don't even have that high of strength values, so just collect this, we'll sell it, we need the money. We totally do. Oh, you can do this too? Oh, you can throw a coin to increase the odds. Interesting, but that's a lot of coins. So what do you get? Oh! Plus 1 max focus. Hands down. That's something that you don't want to not have. What? What sort of English is that? Alright. So Hildebrand is telling us we got to go to the Glittering Mines right here. Oh my god. Amazing thing is the Glittering Mines and the cult device are so close by, which means you have no idea how good this is, because we can just head down over there, activate the cult device in one round, engage all of these different enemies and events around us, and then head over to the Glittering Mines and kick ass, hopefully. I think services rebel, you are so damn poisoned. It's gonna cost you so much. But you need it. Alright, town market. Do you have anything you can sell? I think you do. You have a crude club for 3. You are going to actually use this right now. There we go, 8. Whew! I love it. We're gonna kick arse. Everything else is fine. We don't wanna sell these things. Wait, can I sell from outside? No, of course not. However, I can chain items forward. So, Karen, do you have anything that you want to get rid of? Definitely not. Shadow Man, do you have anything you want to get rid of? You have a rusty blade that you should give to Rebel. And then Rebel, you should sell this rusty blade for one. Go back into the market. Let's take a look. God's Beard. Do you have a God's Beard? You don't have a God's Beard. Buy a God's Beard. Or buy a weapon. What is your weapon? Who are you? You use intelligence, right? You use intelligence. Is there anything intelligence related that you could take advantage of? Not quite. So, yeah. Take the God's Beard. You're at 2 gold. That's fine. We'll give some of the 16 to... Shadow Man, and then Shadow Man is going to give you like around like eight. Okay, cool enough, because now we want to actually how many points do I have left of movement? Good idea to engage this guy. This camp. This is also level 2 druid there, who I dare not touch. But we can also get experience and focus from that. Do not want to fight that guy. Just go over there, end your turn. Karen, it's your time. This only tests your strength. Go check it out. You're gonna restore your focus, so just use up your focus. All of it. That's actually exactly what I wanted. Another point of lore, experience. And now we need to destroy the Chaos Leader. The Chaos Leader will give us keys to the Glittering Mines directly adjacent to it. Meanwhile, I'm gonna send what is the radius here? Oh, cool. We can attack that guy and then also like heal up. Leave. Oh wait, I couldn't leave after using the services. That's okay. We're gonna engage in combat with this guy, and then we're gonna move out. I think Karen... I'm down for Karen to use the town services, actually, while Shadow Man goes and picks up this buff here. And then we'll make our way to the Chaos Leader camp, and maybe even engage this Forest Nibbler in combat. So we might just go up from here. We have 9 rounds to enter the Glittering Mines. I think we will be okay. I'd rather be level 2 by the time we enter the caves, but I doubt that is going to be the case very much. But we're gonna go up here, we're gonna go over here, and then we can even like go up here and back down. There's also treasure here very close to the secondary objective here, but not gonna do that. Maybe even Timberwolf can fight us. The options are unlimited here. One of the things that I did miss was this, which I'm okay with, even though experience is very, very important. Maybe Karen will take care of it. And then Karen will do a little shortcut through here, or like over here. Experience multiplication is very important. But anyway, for now, thank you so much for watching. This episode's gone pretty well. I hope you enjoyed it as well. If you did like it, leave a thumbs up on the video. I would greatly appreciate that. And if you're new to my channel, subscribe. And as always, thank you so much for your time and attention. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Hopefully, where we kick Chaos Leader's ass in the Guardian Forest and go move on
to the caves and murder everybody in the glittering mines. Yeah. Goodbye.